So recently we've seen some major updates to both Virtual DJ and Serato DJ Pro, so we wanted to take another look at these two DJ programs and see what's new and what's been changed. This is going to be our head-to-head comparison of Virtual DJ version 2020 and Serato DJ Pro version 2.2.2, which at the time of this recording are the two most current versions. Before we get to the new stuff, I just want to do a quick introduction for those of you who may be new to all of this. So Serato DJ Pro and Virtual DJ are two DJ programs that allow you to DJ mixing music that is either stored on or streamed from your laptop. You can mix, scratch, and control all the tracks that you're playing from your computer using turntables, media players, controllers, or play directly off the laptop. Both Serato and Atomix Productions, which developed Virtual DJ, have been making DJ software for a long time. They have a proven track record of putting out great and reliable DJ software, and their software are used by DJs all over the world. Now, as technology evolves and the needs of DJs change, both Serato and Atomix have been listening to their user bases, and they put out updates to include new features and improvements that their users have been asking for. First, let's take a look at the brand new 2020 version of Virtual DJ, which sports an entirely refreshed user interface. I've talked about Virtual DJ's interface in my previous videos comparing it with other DJ software and how I always felt like the Virtual DJ interface wasn't as modern or even as professional as those other programs. That is no longer a problem in version 2020, and I'm happy to see that the new interface with its dark matte colors and flat design definitely feel more premium. Like previous versions of Virtual DJ, much of the interface is customizable, from the different layouts like Pro and Performance, to the color and position of the waveforms. Even the jog wheel display can be customized to show more or less information. Serato DJ Pro maintains its familiar and well-organized interface, allowing you to choose from several different layouts, show or hide panels for FX, the sampler, and recording your mixes, and displaying your cue points in a list or performance pad layout. There is also a high-res option for DJs who use laptops with higher resolution displays, which delivers a sharper user interface. Now, a brand new interface feature that's found on both of these programs is daylight mode. This is perfect for when you're DJing outside on a bright sunny day and it's difficult to see what's on the screen, especially with dark themed DJ software. In day mode, the software will essentially invert its colors, making it much easier to see the interface. Library management is an important part of DJing, and both programs have tools to organize your digital music collection. Serato DJ Pro lets you create crates of tracks. They can be nested within each other to create subcrates. And you can also create smart crates, which will automatically add any tracks in the library that meet the criteria you set. Virtual DJ lets you do essentially the same thing with their virtual folders and filter folders, and also has tools like Genius DJ that can suggest tracks to play next based on what is currently playing. Virtual DJ can also read your Serato crates. Both programs will keep track of your set histories and allow you to record your mixes. Only Virtual DJ currently has support for broadcasting your mix live via Facebook, YouTube, Twitch, or a radio server. One of the biggest new features to come to DJ software recently is support for music streaming. This is the ability to stream music from an online source directly from within your DJ software. This gives you a massive music library to work with, you no longer need to purchase tracks or albums individually, and it virtually eliminates the possibility of not having a song that somebody requests. Virtual DJ has offered music streaming in the past with services like iDJ Pool, Digitrax, and Deezer, and now in version 2020, SoundCloud and Beatport Link are also available. Serato DJ Pro has also recently added streaming support using SoundCloud and Tidal. You'll need a subscription to the streaming service of your choice to stream music in your DJ software. Once you're set up, you can search for an online track the same way you would search for a track saved on your computer, and you can load it to a deck. Streaming music in DJ software is the direction the industry is heading, so it's great to see both of these programs supporting it. Now, everybody has their own preference of DJ hardware. Some DJs like to use turntables, some like media players like the Pioneer CDJ series or the Denon Prime series, some DJs like all-in-one controllers. No matter what you use, both Serato DJ Pro and Virtual DJ can support using all kinds of hardware. Here's how it works. Serato has a substantial list of hardware that's made by multiple manufacturers that plug and play with their software. But it does need to be officially supported by Serato for it to connect. That official support means the hardware and software are designed to work perfectly together, but it does mean that not every piece of DJ hardware can be used with Serato DJ Pro. Virtual DJ, on the other hand, will support a wider range of DJ hardware, albeit unofficially in some cases, and they're very good about adding support for newly released hardware. Both programs support DVS, or Digital Vinyl System, which allows you to DJ with turntables by using timecode vinyl records. DJs who like to mix harmonically will be happy to know that both Virtual DJ and Serato DJ Pro have the tools to help. For a while now, Serato DJ users have been able to use the Pitch and Time DJ Expansion Pack to shift and sync the key of a track to match another. Clicking the adjustment buttons to shift the key up and down, or clicking the musical note to sync it to the key of the other deck. The music library can also color code the key values of tracks, so you can see at a glance which tracks would be harmonically compatible with the one you're currently playing. Virtual DJ 2020 adds a new harmonic key matching feature, which will sync the keys of two playing tracks if they are within one semitone of each other. Basically speaking, if two tracks can be key matched or harmonically matched without shifting too far in either direction, Virtual DJ 2020 will do it, either automatically or with a simple click. This is great for DJs who like to harmonically mix tracks, add a cappellas over tracks that might not be in the exact same key, and just keep the mix sounding good. Both Serato DJ Pro and Virtual DJ 2020 support video mixing for DJs who mix music videos or use visuals in their sets. You can load a video track to a deck the same way you would for a music track, and the video is output to a display or projector that's connected to your computer. The recently updated Serato Video Expansion Pack is now 64-bit for Mac users, which means significantly better video performance. In Virtual DJ, there are new video transition effects added to the already impressive list of video features in the program. There are some other new features and improvements recently added to both Virtual DJ and Serato DJ Pro. There's a new plays column in Serato DJ Pro that will keep track of how many times you've played a track. Virtual DJ now has an event scheduler that can trigger specific actions to occur at certain times. So now DJs can easily schedule a track, playlist, sample, or video to play at a designated time. The waveforms in Virtual DJ can be positioned below the decks instead of above them, similar to the extended layout in Serato DJ Pro. Most importantly, both of these software developers are dedicated to keeping their software stable and reliable, and they're consistently putting out updates that fix bugs and glitches, which is great. Let's go over the pricing for Serato DJ Pro and Virtual DJ 2020. The license for Serato DJ Pro is $129 US or $9.99 a month if you opt for the subscription service. They also have an Essentials package that includes several of their expansion packs for $11.99 a month or the full suite of features for $14.99 a month. Expansion packs can also be purchased individually, so if you just need DVS support, you can buy that separately. It's up to you to decide which features you need and which licenses or package works best for you. It's worth mentioning that a lot of DJ hardware designed to work with Serato will come with at least the Serato DJ license included, so check Serato's hardware page to see which license, if any, comes bundled with the hardware you use. You can also download the light version of Serato DJ for free to test drive the basic features. Virtual DJ is free for home use without any professional equipment. The Pro license is $299 US or a monthly subscription of $19. Unlike Serato DJ Pro, the Virtual DJ Pro license unlocks all the features of the software, including video mixing, key shifting and matching, and DVS support for vinyl control. Check the comparison chart on Virtual DJ's site to see the different features that each of their licenses offer. So that's a look at some of the new features and improvements in Virtual DJ 2020 and Serato DJ Pro 2.2.2. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and let us know down in the comments which new feature or update you're the most excited for in either one of these programs. If you haven't already, please make sure you're subscribed to the channel for more DJ tips, tricks, and reviews. I'm Joe Moore for Digital DJ Tips. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you in the next one. We'll